on his performances the last couple weeks on Secret, he clearly has top tier mechanical skill. I really think that the Secret can do really good things.
This seems to be a standard opening and now up against Team Secret. I say standard after we've watched it happen in two games in a row.
Yeah.
But it happened when Empire played up against Secret, now Vega doing the same thing. That first ban on the Bounty Hunter, and they're actually going to prioritize the Nyx ban in the first phase. So two Invis heroes, they're removing already from the pool.
Yeah, heroes that can set up kills. So I would guess, because Vega's on Radiant, that may mean that they are either going to they probably want passive farm. Because if you passive farm too much on Radiant, that usually gives Dire the Roche advantage. So, but it would spot ganks a little. And that could be the reason that they're focusing on these Invis heroes. And Draw Ranger, that's basically it. If you have Invis heroes, Draw's a little punished by those in the early mid game, especially if you get behind, you get crushed. So if Vega can just either have a good laning stage or an okay laning stage, they can get to that power window of the 8 to 20 minute mark where Drow is just really strong, makes their team really strong.
I'm wondering how they approach it this time, because before we saw Liquid pick up the VS in the first phase, they tried to almost like block pick up the Drow Ranger a little bit. They also took the OD in that phase, but he was banned in this game, so PA is going to be the first one from Secret.
Great solution. You gap close, Drow Ranger can't get away from you, and you reduce her agility by being in melee range, and you have evasion. It's everything that you want against a hero like Drow Ranger. Unless she silences you from range, and everybody else on your team kills you. So, yep. I mean, but Vlad's alone makes a huge difference. The Vlad's build is, obviously we only see one hero, but it's perfect tier, 4 armor to everybody on your team, more bonus damage, lifesteal to offset all the extra damage that you're taking. It's everything you need in a teamfight hero. So I would love high mobility heroes, gap closers, that kind of thing. It's exactly what Secret needs to draft to counter most Drow strats.
Yeah, and they've got to keep Drow Ranger down, because if she does get anywhere near like that, something like a Hurricane Pike, the Phantom Assassin loses a large portion of that advantage. Just pushed away and the Drow can keep you at bay.
Yeah, and there's ways to play around it, obviously, and even then, Hurricane Pike alone isn't a massive damage item. Ooh, okay.
Hello!
Now that we're... No more consistency, screw that guy.
So, Team Secret, we asked the question. It's obviously going to be a 4-position punch.
Most likely, unless
you're going to run a 3-position, but...
Even that is iffy, and at that point you're probably dual laning anyways, so it's like, is it really 3-position? I think Pudge is in a great place right now. He's really fun to play. Before you kind of had to play him in a core role, but now you can definitely play support. You still have a very good range hook, you have great roaming potential, and an Oracle is going to make this a little iffy. You can Fate's Edict whoever he hooks, if you're within range, that is, and prevent the magic damage. So it could work quite well in lane versus Pudge.
That's the challenge, right? It's actually going to be the range for the Oracle. How do you keep up? Pudge is going to hook someone so far out of position.
Don't get hooked. That's all.
That's a better way, but you're going to need vision to avoid that.
Yeah. I mean, it's honestly a very, very early Pudge pick. Like, if anybody gets hooked, Drow could silence. Oracle can ulti them. Can Fate's Edict them. Normally, you grab Pudge when you know that you have a reliable save. Like, if somebody is, if you're against a Faceless Void and you know, oh, he gets chronoed, I'm gonna hook him right out. Or somebody's gonna get chain stunned from a Yule, so you hook him out. That's the kind of stuff that Pudge counters. Arguably, it's a gap closer because you're pulling Drow out of position, but it's still unreliable. And at some point, Drow will get something like a Manta and make it even harder to hook. So I'm excited to see the Pudge. I think it was a very big gamble, though.
Yeah, it seems like this is also one of these things. I don't want to say I'm going to go from the Book of Swindles, or Puppy is going from the Book of Swindles, but you like to go for a bit of a odd pick in the early phase just to throw your opponent off. So you don't know exactly what the draft's going to do. It makes you think more, makes you burn your extra time. Like, Secret already knew what they're going to do. They banned the Wind Ranger, they're taking away the combo that Vega used yesterday. Mm-hmm. The IO ban's pretty standard now in the second phase,
especially with a PA and a Pudge, two melee heroes that could really benefit from extra survivability, gap close, chase, that kind of thing. It's a very common thing that MVP Phoenix did at TI, actually, just high mobility heroes that can constantly fight and outplay their opponents. And I'm sure that pieces of that could be what Secret are looking for. So I like the IO ban. With that said, about the early Pudge pick to throw your opponents off, I don't think Vega's fazed by this at all here. Oracle Drow, super standard. It makes up for Oracle's weaker damage, more expensive mana cost. Oracle should do better in lane than normal. It just comes down to the snowball a little bit. And I think, based on the hero picks right now, at least, Vega, if they just get through that it's kind of scary laning stage, they should be able to stomp mid game.
You know what would make this actually perfect is Team Secret showing Wings how it was done. Pick the techies with the pudge.
Run
the techies pudge dual off lane with a PA safe lane.
Okay, but
let the dream be a reality pudge.
Well, when you pick Drow, you know you're gonna get a lot of ranged heroes, and then it's just like techies is already not the best idea.
Yeah.
If they get a gem, or they don't even need a Quallian Blade, just one gem in your set, pretty much. So that was always going to be a gamble. I would say even tiny techies might be better than the pudge techies, that's for sure.
Well, Team Secret is now up to them for their choice. You're still going up against an Oracle, so just straight up burst damage might not be the greatest way to go. You've got enough gap closes on the draw, so how do they fill out their lanes? If you've got a roaming pudge...
Well,
if we just assume it's a roaming pudge, how do you feel the rest?
With this talking about roaming, maybe. I think it's going to be Pylite Eye pudge. Now, something that Pylite Eye in the past has done to historically, I don't know if he was on Secret at the time or Cloud9, but there was a small period where he would consistently pick Tiny and do support Tiny and do that kind of bullshit, pull out the large camp, throw it to your wave, and then do a side pull on the mid lane.
You think he's going to do the same thing with a hook?
You can always... that's still in the game. People just kind of stop doing it, but it's always there. The reality is that Pudge usually just needs level 2 to start moving around the map, and they'd rather gank, but you could probably just sit mid and do that repeatedly and really gimp your opponent mid, possible.
What stops you from doing that as like a third position Pudge? Like, we see a lot of offlaners pick up Iron Talon doing that. What if he just starts doing the pull and then he always got the farm under the tower?
Then your carry pushes and the enemy supports can do whatever they want and get maximum value. So if your offlane just goes to jungle, what your supports should do is get either maximum efficiency for themselves with lots of levels, or they should just crap on the safe lane or the mid lane of the enemy team. Gank the mid a lot. That's why being in the offlane and taking a lot of damage is sometimes good, because then you know the supports are there and not ganking your mid hero. So yeah, you can do it. It's always there. It's the same as, that's why you can just AFK Legion farm for 10 minutes. But if your opponents are not idiots, they will get something out of that, or pressure you, or pick a roaming Ricky to steal your experience.
Well, no idiots allowed in this game. The Doom is coming back for Vega. They did it in combination with the Wind Ranger in the mid, and they did run a 4-position Doom Vega in their game yesterday.
It was really effective against the mid, although they don't know who the secret mid is yet. Could be PA. Could even be Pudge, who knows? But roaming Doom, still very effective. High HP, high regen. The only thing he's super weak to, perhaps, is physical damage, which Secret has a good amount of right now with PA. So it could work. With that said, Doom is also very effective against PA. Now, PA does do damage with right clicks, but the biggest value about her in the early mid game is the fact that her Stifling Dagger and her Blink Strike cooldown are very low. That's the build. You have to be able to make up for your lack of farm potential by having ultra mobility in fights and the steroid skill of 100 attack speed out of Blink Strike. That's what you have to abuse. If you Doom him, it's a lot harder to get that damage up.
Timber will now be our next call we see up for Team Secret, combining it with the PA. So a lot of melee against potential. It's potential kiting. Like, the Doom can just hold the Timbersaur in place, but even then, like, you've got that silence, then you've got the draw silence. If she levels up Gust a lot, Timber's going to have a lot of issues.
Yeah, I kind of agree. If there could be a situation, again, same thing as we talked about yesterday, where you don't hit that armor item after your HP fast enough, and I can definitely envision Timbersaw just getting blown up by just Oracle and Drow Ranger alone. Heavy nuke damage, heavy physical damage, plus silences. That's a dead hero in a lot of cases. Now, again, Pudge. Sit him behind that. Sit him far enough back. Whoever gets doomed, hook him out. But they didn't plan for this. The Pudge was right there after the draw pick. But they have some solutions. The bat is also going to be hard. Now Timbersaw doesn't have an easy 1v1. That's a very nice thing that Vega waited this long for the bat for that reason. Like, Timber can win that lane, but I would say Bat Riders are definitely better pre-6. That's a huge advantage. But after 6, Timber can definitely get some kills.
So you're looking to see Timber and Bat Rider in the same lane?
Not necessarily. It just allows Vega the potential to do that if they want to, depending on how the rest of the lanes splash out.
Well, it does make a lot of sense that Vega would just push the Bat Rider to the off lane. Like, the other option is they throw him in the mid. But
against PA, I wouldn't do that.
Yeah. The question is also then, where does the PA go? Like, do you put the PA in the mid, or do you secure her the farm on the safe lane? Is there an advantage to either?
I don't know if she needs a guarantee. PAs, if they get aggro tri-laned, she's definitely a weak carry hero at level 1, level 2. So there's issues there, but in terms of guaranteeing her farm, I think she's mostly fine, usually.
Yep.
But if she dies too much, it's not good at all.
Invoker. That'll be the last one for Vega, so it will be a 4-position Doom locked in. 3 Batrider, 1 Drow, and the 2 Invoker.
So I would expect PA versus Invoker mid. It's a decent matchup. Invoker has very low armor recently, kind of similar to the PL versus Invoker matchup. You just hit him, and you trade well. With Evasion on top of that and a 4-man shield, I think that should be okay for PA.
With the Invoker, is it worthwhile going Quaswex for like looking for the burn on the Timber Saw, knowing that Drow can sort of offset you?
Or
do you go all
out
damage with the X-Sort?
You almost never go for Quaswex, but... I always look at him like, this looks like a really good Quaswex, but you never expect it. Like, you're right, very low mana pools, but there is still a keeper. Does mana drain, is that really effective against PA? I would say no. Like, she's going to have Bottle, maybe a Magic Stick, because there's a Batrider, and they have a Caudle. I would say he still goes damage. You still go Exhort. Let your Batrider go around Lassoing, throw the Sunstrike down. That's a kill. I think he still goes Exhort this game, definitely.
So rely on your teammates to actually do the work. Lifestealer was the last pickup by Team Secret. We didn't even touch on him at all. Do you think that's going to be, like, are we looking at combos? Is this meant to be a rotation kind of thing? Or is this just that we need a really, really strong safe laner who's going to have that immunity? You don't have your Juggernaut in this case. It's going to be the Lifestealer.
I mean, Rage is useful, but I don't think that's what it's about. It's, again, about gap closing. You need somebody that will help the PA get on top of their opponents and do the damage. And that's definitely what Lifestealer can do. And he has a really easy way to do that early. He can infest PA. And then as soon as she jumps in, that's a dead hero. Assuming they don't TP. Oh, Sioma's just gonna die here.
Oh, maybe. He's got support coming over the hill. Puppy's gonna see it thanks to the Observer Ward and Sentry he put down. So Puppy, locked in position.
Oh,
FN, the call snap, the timing. FN, he's moving over.
Denied.
See myself out, shall I?
First blood, I cut you, and I split you, and I killed you.
There with Puppy suiciding, he lost almost nothing. I don't know if he wasted a clarity or what, but and Fred bought out before he died. He bought a Quelling Blade and a TP. And the lane hasn't even spawned yet. Like, this is, it just got him a free Quelling Blade. He gets a bit of experience.
Mag?
Oh,
he wanted to come for the room.
The battle begins.
He did grab Quas, of course, because for the cold snap. Absolutely worth it, because they thought they would get the kill. I think he may still go Exhort. We'll see. We'll see what he does with this skill build here. Back to the top lane MP. Lifestealer will just farm, and that should be straightforward.
It's kind of funny. You were talking about, like, Pylai Dai actually being on the Pudge from previous times, but this time we have Puppy.
A little interesting to see how the playstyle adjusts, basically. Puppy will probably just... I mean, if he gets on top of the Invoker or gets behind him and the PA's there with Dagger and maybe an Orb of Venom, it should be a kill.
Well, that's going to be painful for FN.
Yeah.
Pylai Dai playing in what I like to refer to as the Jimmy spot.
Yeah, basically. The Jimmy spot has more entrances than it used to, but I kind of like this kind of pressure, and I think that's maybe one mistake a lot of Caudle players do. They just stand in the lane, and then they blast. But just a little bit of tricky stuff like that can really start you off on some good regen trades, that is.
Well, at least it balances out the lanes for Team Secret. Mid one, as well as Iceberg. They get to go head-to-head in the mid. It's probably going to get a little bit more difficult for mid one, but with the Quaswex build, there's not at least Forge Spirits to harass mid one out of the lane, but FNG kind of does that. And again, he got that Pack Wolf aura.
Yeah.
It's the same thing he got yesterday.
With that said, he did stack it first, so he wasn't ultra lucky. He was just a little lucky. It's like 2 out of 4 chances of getting
mid one. That call snap. There you go, the tornado. It actually reached him mid one. Is he going to survive back behind the tower?
Wow.
Forward, realizing he was practically dead anyway.
And that is a Quas Wex. That's 2 points in Wex there. Maybe not expected from his opponent due to the fact that he did get cold snap for the kill, but that's a huge kill.
You got to give a little bit more respect right there to Pylai Dai. Doom denies himself up, but Perev's going to find that kill. Pylai Dai has been hitting these Illuminates time and time again. Just lets Forev do a little bit more work as Seema. He's still got the tower for protection.
This is actually a really good duel lane, because the Chakra Magic reduces the cooldown of one of his skills. Whirling Death is 6 seconds. That means he could Whirling Death, wait like 3 or 4 seconds, and then Whirling Death again. Especially if you have trees in that, that's 200 pure damage in the early game. Just for one skill point. That's amazing. He might die though. That'll be okay.
Luckily for him, they don't really have enough slow yet. The Drow Ranger control with her movement, like unless she's got boots as well as level 2 arrows, she's probably not able to keep that control slow on the Timbersaw.
MP's having some trouble top two. He's getting zoned quite heavily by Mag. He is still farming better, but he's got to be careful here. With Rage, he can almost always survive. It'll give him a reset on Napalm, but...
Secret brought support to bottom lane. They just, I believe, dewatered the Observer Ward that was down there. So right now, Vega should have no idea that the Pudge... Okay, now they definitely know. FNG, ooh, he gets hooked up. There goes your Rot. Your Illuma's coming out from Paladai. Hits perfectly. And the Doom rotation not working out for Vega. As Secret preemptively moving down the Pudge.
Yeah, it's a little tough. Like, the Doom in the previous time that they played it was just pressuring mid constantly. But against a PA, it's a lot harder. Very mobile hero, can slow from range, can blink strike. Oh, he's going to go mid this time, though.
Yeah, but mid one, he's got a creep wave to jump out to.
That was so lucky. If he got hit by the Infernal Blade there, he might just die, but he got lucky. 20% evasion. FNG is having a little trouble hitting the mark, and it's basically because Timbersaw is hard to kill. The Pudge does a massive amount of damage if he hooks, because you can rot all the way until you suicide, basically. Puppy's getting stuff done, basically.
It's kind of also fun to watch Puppy's positioning. Like, you know, he just commits suicide at the moment, but he's been fighting in from around side the Radiant Jungle, and the Observer Wards, which are down from Vega, you got one on the Dire side of the mid-river, you got another one up in the top, blocking up the camp. So it works when Pudge is playing behind the heroes, but instead Puppy is moving in from the Radiant side of the attack.
Yeah, MP doing his best to kill Mag. He got low, but Firefly to the top of the cliff, and no issues there. Still under-farmed, but he is getting levels. Could transition him into the jungle, but if Secret continues to pressure like this, it's going to be really hard for Vega. I mean, Drow Ranger has only 12 last hits at 4 minutes here, completely getting outfarmed by 3 of Secret's cores and being pressured in the lane. He's out of regen already now.
Yeah, if he can stick around here long enough and hit level 6, then you can normally play catch up quite easily on the Drow,
yeah,
because that's when you get your money back from your towers. But right now, Steam's having to hug him, so getting that quick level 6 is really difficult.
Yeah, the forcing the support to be next to you constantly so you don't die is a massive impact that this dual lane accomplishes. So Secret's farming better, and it's delaying the Drow 6. And that means that Iceberg on the mid lane has less damage than you normally expect, just because the Precision Aura doesn't get as leveled up.
Iceberg in the mid lane might also have a couple of other problems. The fact that Puppy is rotating over. This is nighttime, so we can get this close without Iceberg seeing him. And now, okay, Puppy makes it a little bit more obvious.
Yeah.
And goes for a semi-blind hook, but bottom lane, Pileye. Well, FNG, the chase is on. They get the ghast off, but the nuke is there. Pileye will drop, thanks to Seema. Fred looking for the revenge!
Yep, I thought the Timber Chain would hit one of those 8 trees in his way, but he did get the damage.
Pudge is coming down too. Seema, he may not be ready for this one. Puppy, he's got the movement speed with the haste, so he can just rot his way through this one. Hook Seema back in again. Pudge will find the kill, even though Ferev helps with a Whirling Death.
Now, pure damage from Meat Hook makes all the difference there. Fate's Edict wasn't enough to stop it, and Puppy's Roam has been super effective. He's got 2 deaths, but both have been suicides, so really he's 1-0-2 at the moment. Huge impacts coming from him, and basically every lane is scared. Iceberg is always worried every time the dagger comes out. Is the hook going to land? Maybe not this time because Pudge was just bottom, but makes the lane harder. They're not as able to get as many last hits because they don't feel comfortable being in an aggressive position.
They're going to find for the top rune. Iceberg's moving out for a mid one in a good, like, feeling like he can go for this. The Illuminate's going to fly out thanks to the Tornado, interrupting Pileye Die a little bit earlier, but they already found the kill on the Invoker. FNG, the Infernal Blade, is going to wear off this effect now. Mid one. He even gets a crit on the Stifling Dagger. But there's no follow-up here. They've already got what they want. They kill off the mid laner. They get back to the lane and farm up.
Their rotations have just been amazing on Secret. All cores sit, and the supports are rotating perfectly. And occasionally, you do want to rotate a core.
Oh, sure, Seema. They smirked. Puppy, if he lands this hook, then Seema should potentially die here. There's no rune that's going to save him from a Puppy. Okay, the Illuminate's off target. Now they drag him back in range of the Rot. Pileye Die getting nuked. He's trying to play the Fog of War around the tree line. Can't do it. To Seema.
I think that's still okay though, because the support's dead now. That means Drow Ranger is probably going to back off. He's in base. It's 7 minutes in. Drow just hit level 5, and she's only got 20 CS. This is a massive advantage for Secret. Like, limiting his offensive potential does everything. And pretty soon here, Lifestealer is going to start participating in some of these ganks.
It's kind of great that you mentioned him. Like, Lifestealer, we haven't felt any real presence from him just yet. Like, MP rotates off the lane, and Drow actually goes to his lane.
Yeah. I've seen the impact of his last hit, so he's 49 at 7 minutes. I don't even think he's missed a last hit. I'm sure he has, because he's against a Batrider. Once in a while, you have to back up, but man, it's been a perfect game for MP so far.
Well, FNG was waiting on that top lane. Looks like the movement up.
Gank mid as well, mid one, but he should be fine.
Yeah, MP scattered out. He's still going to open wounds as well as Infest with the movement in from Puppy. They're going to find that hook, drag the Drone Ranger in. FNG wants to try and fight this one with the Infernal Blade on Puppy. He's going to be low, can't deny himself up, however, thanks to the damage that was there. It is the Drow killing off the Pudge before Lifestealer takes his life.
Yeah,
small upside, you get the experience for the Drow.
Yeah, I think it was okay for Vega there. Any experience that the Drow gets is going to be worth it.
She's almost level 6, like only 30 points shy of it.
Yeah, if she would have hit 6 there, it would have been like absolutely worth it, but still level 5, and they lose their safe lane. That's not the position.
And they lose Mag. The Chakram thrown out as, Pylai Dai wants to try and help him go in again. Chakra up on Ferev.
Fred's just doing so well. I mean, he played Timbersaw and he absolutely wrecked last game as well. Guy's consistently been one of the best mechanical players in the world. Always been on top leaderboards, even in China, playing with lag delay from Korea or whatever place they were living at the time. He's making it work too.
I love how the only way Vega believe they can, like, they just gotta buff the Drow up to level 6. She now hits it, but they put her into the jungle. It's like, just get your level 6, because the Invoker needs this. He's going Course Wex. He needs to have that amplification of damage, which now he does, sitting at 68 plus 57.
It helps, but it only does so much. Like, this is the I'm really poor on Drow. You buy Tango and you jungle with it.
Oh, the Tornado. Here they go again with the hold, mid one. Oh, the hookup Puppy is there for the save. They try to throw the nuke and ends up healing up mid one even more.
Yeah, and Pudge justifies his value again. He's under-leveled now, level 4, 9 minutes, but I don't think that matters. He probably won't get a channeled ulti anyways. He's got what he needs, Tranquil Soul Ring. He can cast all the hooks, he can stack camps, he can even jungle them occasionally.
You know what this reminds me of? It reminds me of, like, the Roaming Earthshaker days.
Yeah,
like always there, like, the Fissure would be a block save, in this case, like, it's a pull save out with the hook.
Pi's pretty dead bottom, I think.
Yeah.
He doesn't even have mana leak, so there's actually nothing he can do.
He spent all of his money, like, maybe he can buy an extra TP scroll with the 50 gold he's sitting on, that's exactly what he does. But he's got his Tranquil Boots on the Keeper of the Light, so his sustain should be really, really quite good from now.
I'm quite unsure about Oracle stealing that kill. I really feel, I mean, that could have been more gold going to Batrider for a faster Blink Dagger, but what does Oracle need? I guess he kind of needs Arcane Boots because of the mana cost increase, but surely Blink Dagger would get you more gold in the long run. That felt like a bit of a steal. MP's got Armlet as well in the top lane, one kill on him. Doom is under leveled, level 5. If he gets on top of Doom, Doom dies, 100%.
Let's have Doom has no extra support to TP in for the moment. Vega.
Okay,
yeah, they're going to be too late. Puppy's already moving in. There goes your Stifling Dagger. Saw him up, hook him into the tree line. And then no support will come, so more optimistic from FNG, thinking he can do anything about that tier 1 tower.
This draft is so cool, actually. Just all it takes to make Pudge good in this game is to have a PA in it. Because you have a 6-second cooldown, 100% slow ability, that gives you the easiest hooks ever. Or 50%, sorry. But it's still a massive slow in the early game. Just one dagger, let him hook, you get all this bonus damage, and they're out of position. It's just fantastic.
It's kind of funny, like it was semi-nerfed, but I haven't really seen a situation yet, like yesterday or today, where the range of Stifling Dagger has been a problem.
That's because it's only for, like, level 1, level 2, basically, that the range is bad. After that, it's around where it used to be. So it's just a nerf to early game PA roaming, pretty much. You could probably still make it work, you just have to be closer to cast in the first place.
Pylai Dai starting the recall, they're going on FN. And who's going to be in range for it? Who's actually coming in? Of course, it's mid one. The easy jump forward. You're going to go for the gust back. There was no other stun that was going to affect him, so FN's TP out was always going to be successful.
Yeah, I don't think anybody would have worked that. Maybe Pudge if he dodged the silence, but a little scary.
Ooh, it's kind of funny, like, when you look at it from Team Secret, like, the heavy lack of stuns that arrive. Like, obviously, they got huge amounts of damage. Wow. But until you got that dismember, that's kind of it, right?
Yeah, but that's okay. You don't always need stuns to win games. It just helps in certain circumstances. Sioma's in trouble. He's going to have to ulti himself, I think.
That Illuminate's coming in. Is he going to use it? He'll save it.
It's just not worth it. He's going to die no matter what. He wanted to wait. If Open Wounds came out too early, he could cast it and probably get away, but he held it. MP was smart about that. Easy kill.
So a 12-minute Bloodstone onto Ferev.
That's really fast. You know that armor window we were talking about? He's going to be fine, guys.
The one we had yesterday where I was like, I got to get two plate mills just to try and balance us out. FNG! Well, With no infest pop, it's not enough damage to find the kill, but it won't matter forever.
He's
got his, yeah, he's gonna shark him up in right now, and the damage is more than enough. There goes your first chain. Up to Mag, has to play the hillside out, turns around, FN's moving over, Gust is available, but MP already into the rage, they're trying to go on for Rev, but FN, he came too close to MP, lose the advantage, the life, he doesn't do anything, and Tibbethor, now it's stuck.
Time lost with me.
I mean, the base level of this game is that Frev hasn't missed a single Timbersaw skill in like the last three engagements. Every skill he throws, he gets a kill. It's never dodged. And that just makes a massive impact. Drow tries to show up, they kill her as well, and then their synergy just comes together. Like, Chakra Magic on any of their heroes is amazing. Dagger plus Hook is amazing. They have so many solutions to any issue that Vega throws at them. And they're far behind.
And Ferev just keeps going for more. If Vega are far behind, then this Timbersaw's gonna become more and more effective. 17 Bloodstone charge is probably gonna be a lot higher by the end of this game.
Yeah. You know what we're gonna also see too? Chakra Magic on PA double dagger.
Oh.
We're gonna see people just die. Be like, dagger, dagger. Dead. Once he gets his Deso, he's very close.
I wonder what the RNG is going to be like with the crit, too.
Well,
that would be, I mean, really sad.
It's 50% chance to land a crit, so it's usually, you're usually not going to get one crit, but that doubles your chance with a normal dagger, so.
Mm-hmm.
You could go some kind of cheese build with this if you really wanted to, like even like Deso Rapier or something.
At this point with Secret, because you've obviously got the Lifestealer, is it worthwhile just going in for Roshan? Or should you finish like off the tier 1 tower first? Or like, you don't want to give Vega the opportunity to counter you?
Yeah, I think just killing heroes is so much easier. You're so far ahead, you've got more than enough physical damage, you don't have to cheese this. Don't give them an opportunity to fight you when Rosh is low, and you've lost half your HP by getting hit by Rosh. It's just not worth it.
Oh, Mag doesn't see him coming. Pylite, I just got to put the ward on the hillside there. Smoke did break. And now they put an Observe Ward, actually not on the hill, they put it a little bit further down. They've got the Lifesteal infest inside of mid 1. Looks like Pilot Eye just has to go back to defend the tier 1 tower. Secret haven't found what they're looking for with this smoke.
Yeah, and if nobody defends the tower, it's obvious that they're smoked, so that's why Pilot Eye had to go back. But he was a little too late. If they had the ward down a bit faster, maybe Pilot Eye with the Observers instead of Puppy, they could have gotten the kill, but they haven't lost that much. It's one smoke, they're going to see all of Vega top, and that's exactly when they start roshing. Unless they really want to fight, but they're kind of out of position. If they could take Rosh right now and get mid tier 1 or pressure both lanes.
They're actually in a position where, yeah, they can pressure both the tier 1 tower mid as well as the tier 2. They smoke up next to the tier 1 tower. So this is a rotation. The Lifestealer is still inside of mid 1, so he'll have double infest.
They're recalling Timber too. This is a pretty good idea. I kind of wish they would just pressure mid and bottom, but I guess giving a trade to a team that's losing bad is iffy. But the tower's dead already. Like, they're going to be there late.
I think they just want the fight anyway. If they got the confidence and they can get the initiation, they won't really care. Sentry Wars down, mid one's running in, the Hulk blind from Puppy doesn't find the mark. Still that infest damage, they get the last two and they hold MP in position, but the rage protects him. He can move over to Seema. Ferev so low, they want that kill, but the heal is now actually helping Ferev. And he gets...
He got it so fast that it's like, it wasn't even like he had a lot of bloodstone charges. It was just so early that his typical respawn was like 30 seconds. Instantly up. He gets a play mail now. That'll make all the difference there. He did look a little squishy, but silences tons of right clicks and magic damage. That's all he needs. Play mail cloak. That puts Timber in his safe zone. So it kind of worked. They did lose some heroes, but I think ultimately that was fine for Seeker to accomplish. They lose the tower, but again, killing Vega heroes.
If they can still also get a tower in return, like MP's already beaten down this tier 1 tower. But Vega have moved into position to try and hold this off.
There was no lasso, by the way. They did use in the last fight, and they still get the tower. Late fortify actually cost them so much.
Oh, Drow tried at the blinding line. And for what?
They need... I look at the freeing in mid one. They need to have this cycling dagger. They need to have the slow and then the jump in damage.
And Mag will end up dying still so far away from his blink dagger. They just can't dictate the terms of the fight.
Yeah.
They don't have the initiation.
And they're out the mobility on Secret is far better as well. They get to choose when they initiate. They can't blink in on Batrider because he went drums first, and I don't even know if Blink would have been better. In most cases, he's going to be the one that gets gone on, and he needs the HP and the movement speed to help out.
Well, it looks like Team Secret, they are going to stop on Roshan. Pylai, Dai can easily hold the mid lane out while Timber pushes the bottom.
Just really straightforward, Rosh. Lots of damage from Lifestealer. They can open wounds Rosh as well to heal from this if they want. All it takes is two. And in the meantime, two heroes farming, one hero in position for help if needed.
How do you even apply damage to Ferev now? Like, it's almost like the Oracle nukes are the only things that they've got to really work with. Because get the plate mail on, Drove Ranger doesn't have enough items to justify saying, hey, she's going to actually hit hard. And this Invoker is still, like, he doesn't have a main item. He's got a hand of Midas.
Yeah, and he had to buy that as well. And that's one of the issues with Quaswex. You get the Midas slower than you would on Exhort. And you're not able to also contribute to the map globally while just AFK farming. So this is the build he had to do to guarantee that he could be relevant late game, especially because their early game is good. Because if you just say, well, I'll just rush an Orchid and try to win the game there, as soon as they get BKB, your item's worthless and you've lost. You're not going to catch up and farm.
So how do you build now if you're the Invoker? Is it just like the straight up Aghanim Scepter and...
He's picked up a drum first, so that gives them some teamfight mobility. I actually like that idea that... They need to buy aura items, and they need to win team fights. And there's gold advantage on Secret, so they need to grab items that'll be good for them.
Another good opportunity.
Oh,
for Rev,
the tornado, the call snap for Beta.
The Inferno beckon.
He gets that kill if he tornadoes there, but it missed. It just simply missed. It would have done.
It's because he chained forward. The tornado was like just after.
Exactly. The same time that he tried to tornado, Frev also did the timber chain down, and it would have done about 350 magic reduced down to 280.
Oh, Pylai die. He managed to just get the recall. Mag thought he had an easy kill on Pylai die, but mid one gets pulled in. Mid one not actually that healthy as you start to see the.
Book definitely does.
Especially if you kill him with it. He was absolutely fine there. Little low on mana, but again, he's got a Soul Ring Tranquil. Just the easy build up here. And Puppy's doing super well this game. Everybody on Secret is doing super well. Nobody's having a bad game. They're completely controlling the map, and it's just going to scale more and more in their advantage.
Vega need to get some kind of lucky pick off. Right now, the hook is the Observer Ward, which Iceberg has up on that hillside. It's about to time out. And Puppy, well... In the last seconds of the ward, literally 12 seconds, he's going to get the 100 gold from it.
Basher on FNG top, he's definitely dead.
Well, suppose there, Tornado, they wade the rage out, and with the gust, the EMP is going to burn him out. You got the Fortune's End slowing him down too, but mid...
Pretty good for Vega. I wouldn't be surprised if they get gold from that one, but they're going to lose the tower as well, and that's just not going to be worth it. A good kill on MP. Thought he'd get the Doom. Doom's a little too tanky, though. It's just more and more map pressure. Like, Vega has so much trouble getting kills. That was the ideal circumstance. Solo hero that
helps
so
ahead. Oh, not again! Another!
It just keeps piling and piling more and more gold and experience advantage, and they still have Aegis, so PA has no chance of dying anytime soon. 3k gold in her bank. I think she just gets like a BKB next and just jumps on the Drow Ranger every fight. Maybe Vlad's. We'll see.
I just jumped on the Drow anyway. Doom is at the point where he's dooming up a Pudge. Not the greatest target in the world, especially when you're now meddling, lost everything.
The ghost walk.
But they're still finding pick-off after pick-off, plus taking buildings at the same time.
They just can't stand up to anything. The Vlad's helps, but Doom just got blown up from half HP with a crit. Same deal for Oracle. He's having trouble staying alive, and Invoker's just not doing enough damage. They never got to that stage where Tornado EMP would have been good.
I think Coddle is actually doing more damage, and he'll do even more soon. He's almost finished up his Aghanim Scepter.
Yeah.
Like 300 gold till an Ags on Coddle, and we're only 22 minutes into the game.
And his levels are great too. He's level 11 now at 22 minutes. Especially getting to that 11 to 16 mark on Coddle does everything. More mana, more nukes. more effective mana leak from farther away.
I was actually wondering with the Axe coming so quickly for Pilot Eye, if it was worth him skipping the second point in his ultimate.
It still does buff the level of Blinding Light and Recall. So faster Recall, lower cooldown Blinding Light. So it's, you can delay it if you want to, yeah. But usually I think it's justified getting 2 points once you have Axe. I really like Blinding Light though, that's just me.
I kind of like Mana Leak, so I'm fine either way.
Yeah, I mean, cast range can be nice. At 2 points of Mana Leak I would do it for, but maybe not three.
Oh, looks like Vega grouping up on the top lane. Got an Observe Ward watching around their own Ancients.
That's their safe zone, basically. The jungle is not theirs. That is controlled by Secret, that's for sure. So this at least gives them an Ancient camp and a large camp.
I wonder if this movement is also so secret. Like, you know Secret are going to take your tier 2 tower on bottom lane. If you push fast enough, do you get any level of trade?
Or they can maybe bait Doom and turn things around. There's a small chance.
Well, Secret's coming. They can bring back people very quickly. Not just like the TPs, it's the recall.
Oh, yeah.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Unstoppable. Stick it out.
Yeah, again, more kills for free. They even get there late and it still works out. And that's the power of Pudge. All it takes is one hook and they're forced to fight. Doom completely out of position. He didn't even get to use his ultimate. He ran out of mana there.
There's a Lotus Orb over on the Timber now.
Just like, typical Forever Items and a hood, yeah, and a Boots of Travel.
So your magical damage doesn't do enough. You're protecting yourself in case Batrider's even considering lassoing.
You get silenced and it doesn't matter because then you can remove it with Lotus.
So Gust doesn't have this effect.
And that goes for his allies too. It doesn't
and
have to be
Mag
on him.
May be dead. That Firefly's wearing off. He won't get down the hillside in time. Mid one will jump forward and Lifestyle
knows how much this one is in the bag. If he has to, okay, he'll jump down.
He didn't have to do that. That was a kill.
MP had a really good ride going for him there. He could just be lazy, but he's like, oh god, you guys are useless. I have to kill you?
If you want something done right, do it yourself.
Just pop out and AoE. That's how you solve problems.
Blink Dagger Aether Lens over on Puppy. Like, the amount of money, like, what is even the advantage? Like, we're 25 minutes in right now. Net worth is stretched over 21 to almost 22,000 in favor of Team Secret.
I thought this game, I mean, it's only one game.
Yeah, it's the best of three. It's the best of three.
But Secret is owning right now. They're actually completely owning. They're making almost no mistakes. Their draft has been impeccable. Their rotations have been impeccable.
But you do wonder, like what could Faker even do about it? Because the Batrider didn't get the early Blink Dagger, do they have any other real options?
Early engagements had to go a little bit better. That would have helped, but it's tough.
Oh, the hook again. This time it's over on FN. The Blinding Light pushing him back. False Promise. They need more heals on the FN. He starts his TP out with a dismember. Cancels the TP. So... This is the high ground time.
Not looking good. I think one thing that Vega definitely could have done differently, I think the Doom was very ineffective against PA, and the PA was already picked when they picked Doom. They thought that they could get some advantage there, and maybe they should have been able to with Quaswex Invoker and a Doom roam, but the problem was that there was so much pressure on the safe lane, the Drow Ranger got no farmed, it forced Doom to be there, and then in a tri-lane situation, Doom is not nearly as effective. So just by having a really strong tri-lane and a hero like Pudge, it completely threw Vega off, and the hero that they picked became less effective. So that was the really smart thing about what Secret did. They made the Doom useless, and all the other heroes on Vega played about to what they could, but they needed that 5 position hero to be more effective in the laning stage.
So I actually just see 55 armor on Ferev.
I wouldn't
was
be
actually
surprised.
A little, when his reactive armor was up, combining up with the double plate mails he got in his items.
Yeah, it is plate mail number 2, so... Not too surprising here. We'll be Shivas afterwards, so basically countering so much attack speed.
Oh, they should jump forward, FNG. Well, they try and save him getting the initiation. They at least get the Doom on mid one, but when...
the one guy they went on was Doom, but because of Scorched Earth, it gave him double the heal rather than just a regular typical Oracle stuff. So he got massive amounts of survivability there. He's getting 80 HP per second from Scorched Earth during the Oracle ulti. Stays alive.
FN still wants this kill if he can get it. Ferev in the cover of his Lotus Orb. Moving forward, their Stifling Dagger, double. No crit, but the Sharkrams, the double slow they have. Not doing enough work.
They're slowing it, but killing Ferev is almost impossible.
Invoker and Doom are back up again. The TP's coming to the front lines. That's Invoker TPing inside the base, four staff down. He needs this Tornado connect. It will. Sends Ferev up and towards the air. Stifling Dagger, slowing him down, but the Cold Snap Ferev couldn't actually connect on the Timber Chain. Mag on the front lines. Mid one looking for an opening. That Illumina hits hard.
Radiant's middle barracks are under attack.
Amazing how much they controlled that game. And to mark it off, they started with a Pudge pick. It was their second pick. They went PA Pudge. They knew that it could mess up the lanes at Pudge.